25 سال دیگه چیزی به نام رژیم صهیونیستی در منطقه وجود نخواهد داشت به فضل الهی.
And we will act if necessary, not just against Iran's proxies that are attacking us, but against Iran itself.
지금 우리는 그야말로 한치 앞을 내다볼 수 없는 격동의 시대에 살고 있습니다. 미국의 도널드 트럼프 대통령이 예루살렘을 이스라엘의 수도라고 선언한 이후에 미국 대사관을 테라비브에서 예루살렘으로 또 옮겨온다라고 발표를 했죠. 당연히 팔레스타인과 전 세계 아랍 국가들은 큰 반발을 일으키면서 그야말로 한치 앞을 내다볼 수 없는 혼돈의 상태 그 자체라고 할 수가 있죠. 과연 이스라엘은 중동은 앞으로 어떻게 될까요? 또 미국은 어떤 역할을 하게 될까요? 미국의 달라스에 있는 엔타임 미니스트리의 어빙 백스터 목사님을 찾아뵙고 미국에 대해서 그리고 앞으로 이스라엘과 중동에 대해서 마지막 때에 대해서 좀 더 구체적으로 이야기를 좀 들어보는 시간을 가지려고 합니다. 목사님 이렇게 또 만나뵙게 돼서 반갑습니다. Nice to meet you again.
Oh, thank you.
목사님 한 2년 만에 뵙는 것 같은데 건강은 좀 어떠십니까?
Well, everything is just wonderful, and we're working day and night because it's the end time. We have to work like it's the end time. My health is tremendous, and everything is good.
알겠습니다. 저희도 목사님이 계속 건강하시기를, 건강하셔야 또 우리 나중에 한국에도 방문하실 텐데 건강하기를 바라겠습니다. 지금 미국의 도널드 트럼프 대통령이 대통령직을 한 지가 1년이 이제 넘어가고 있는데 목사님이 보시기에는 도널드 트럼프 대통령이 1년의 기간 동안 하나님이 보시기에 가장 기쁘게 하신 일은 어떤 거라고 보십니까?
Well, I don't think there's any doubt whatsoever. When he recognized Jerusalem as the capital of the nation of Israel, when all the other nations said no, that definitely was the number one achievement because God said, I will put my name in Jerusalem. So if God puts his name there, where should the United States Embassy be? Certainly it should be Jerusalem. So I definitely believe that in God's eyes, that one move was the greatest thing he's done. Of course, there have been other things, such as withdrawing the United States from the world government apparatus, which he has moved to get us out of the Paris Climate Accord, to get us out of the Trans-Pacific Partnership and all these world government organizations. So he's done a lot of things that really line up with what God's will would be for the United States of America.
예전에 목사님하고 인터뷰할 때 마지막 때 일어날 일들 중에 하나가 지금 예루살렘의 성전산에 제3성전이 세워지게 될 것이고 그곳에 적그리스도가 오게 될 것이고 이런 이야기를 하셨는데 그럼 마지막 때에 일어날 일들의 그 스케줄 속에서 이 도널드 트럼프 대통령이 예루살렘을 이스라엘의 수도라고 선언하는 게 어떤 의미가 있습니까?
Well, it has everything to do with it. It has created so much opposition because the United Nations sees this move as a challenge to its authority. The United Nations sees itself as a world government, and it will be the world government through which the Antichrist will rule the world. So when President Trump said, we're not listening to your demands, that we keep our embassy in Tel Aviv, we are recognizing Jerusalem as Israel's capital. This is seen as a direct affront to the authority of the UN. It's not going to stop there because the Bible says that that's the issue that will trigger the Battle of Armageddon. In Zechariah 14:2, it specifically states there, I will gather all nations against Jerusalem to battle. Now, that doesn't mean every nation on earth will have their armies there. It means that the United Nations, representing all the nations on earth, will bring a force, a peacekeeping force, they'll call it undoubtedly. They'll bring a force against Israel for the Battle of Armageddon. The Bible tells us that Russia, Iran, Turkey, Ethiopia, Libya will be among the nations that will contribute forces to that UN force. So this move that was just made is going to continue to fester until ultimately it will result in the Battle of Armageddon. And of course, it's at Armageddon that Jesus Christ returns to the earth, defeats the Antichrist and his religious partner, the false prophet, and that's when we're going to crown him King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
그럼 목사님이 보시기에는 이번에 도널드 트럼프 대통령이 예루살렘을 이스라엘의 수도라고 선언한 그 자체만으로도 훨씬 더 우리는 마지막 때를 향해서 달려가고 있다 이렇게 보실 수 있는 거죠?
Yes, definitely. This is all in the plan of God. Now, we know that there is a final seven-year period that's described in the Bible, which will begin with the signing of a peace agreement between Israel and the Palestinians. When that agreement is signed, we will enter the final 7 years, and that final 7 years is going to be absolutely full of prophetic fulfillment. President Trump said when he was running for office that his number one goal would be to get this deal done between the Palestinians and the Israelis. He called it the ultimate deal. He said, I don't know whether I can get it done or not, but I would like to try. President Trump sees himself as a big deal maker because of his business background. He actually wrote a book called The Art of the Deal. So he thinks, if anybody can make this deal, I think I can. He's been working on it very diligently since his election. And it looked like it was moving along very good. However, when he recognized Jerusalem as Israel's capital, Mahmoud Abbas of the Palestinians said, I'm not talking to you anymore. You cannot be a broker in this peace negotiation. And so he says, I'm not going to do it. However, he is coming under tremendous pressure to change and to go ahead and to consider this deal. Saudi Arabia just met with high Israeli officials in Egypt over the weekend. And they are, according to this report I read, they are pressuring Mahmoud Abbas to accept Trump's peace plan. We don't know yet where it's going to go. We know there's going to be a peace deal. We don't know that President Trump is the one that's going to get it done. But there is going to be a peace deal, and it will trigger the final 7 years to the Battle of Armageddon and the second coming of Jesus.
도널드 트럼프 대통령이 이번에 이렇게 예루살렘 수도 선언을 하게 된 것이 본인의 어떤 정치적인 의지로 그렇게 한 겁니까? 아니면 종교적인 신앙심에 의해서 그렇게 한 거라고 보십니까?
Actually, I don't think either one of those is the main reason. Jared Kushner, his son-in-law, and Jason Greenblatt, his lawyer of 20 years, his personal lawyer, are the two that he assigned to work out this deal between the Palestinians and the Israelis. I believe that when they brought all of the facts after they had worked from January up until November, Mahmoud Abbas had asked them, now give us the American plan. You've heard the Palestinian side, you've heard the Israeli side, now give us the American plan. Trump said, I will, give me 3 months. And that was in September the 1st. So now he gets to December the 1st, the 3 months are up. He now looks at all of the factors. He said to Jared Kushner and to Jason Greenblatt, what's solvable, what's not solvable. I believe they said we can work out everything except one thing. The Palestinians say there's not going to be a deal unless East Jerusalem is our capital. But the Israelis say never. We will never surrender Jerusalem. We can't, because, you know, David said, if I fail to esteem Jerusalem above my chief joy, let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth, let my right hand forget her cunning. They entered into a covenant in 1993 called the Jerusalem Covenant, signed by the prime minister, by the president. It's on display in the Israeli Knesset, that we will never surrender Jerusalem. So I believe Kushner and Greenblatt said to President Trump, this is the issue that we can't solve. So now Trump, as the ultimate deal maker, looked at that and said, well, I think I'll just take that off the table. I'll solve it. Because after all, it became Israel's capital in 1004 BC, and it was their capital for the next over 1,000 years until 70 AD, when the Romans destroyed Jerusalem, and they still look at it as their capital. As soon as the nation was reborn, they made it their capital again. So I think they have a claim, and it's never been the capital of the Palestinians. One day, not one day. So if I don't solve this problem, we can work for years and we'll always come back to this issue and we'll be stuck. So I'm going to preempt everything. I'm going to take it off the table. So he said, we are recognizing Jerusalem as Israel's capital, and we are moving our embassy there. Even though they're screaming and all that, but yet now the nations of the world are saying, hey, Palestinians, you better consider this, because he says it's a good plan, and this may be your last chance to ever get a state. Because if you refuse this, and he says to the Israelis, go ahead and build on the West Bank, go ahead, they're not a peace partner, this will get too far along for you to ever have your own state. This is the only game in town. That's what the head of Saudi Arabia said to Mahmoud Abbas. The Trump plan is the only game in town. So I believe that, being the master negotiator that he is, I believe President Trump said, if I blow it up, it's going to blow up anyway 2 years from now. I might as well do it right now. And he made his move, his bold move. And even though there's a lot of fallout, yet, well, we don't know what's going to happen. Trump may not get it. Someone else may get it. I do not know the answer to that. But we know the Antichrist is going to be involved in the deal when it's done, because the Bible says he will confirm the Abrahamic covenant with many for 7 years. So I know that's a long answer to your question, but that's my understanding.
그래서 그런지 제가 인터넷을 보니까 어떤 사람이 도널드 트럼프 대통령의 사위인 쿠슈너, 유대인이죠. 이 사람이 혹시 적그리스도가 아닌가, 이런 얘기를 인터넷에서 제가 읽은 적이 있었는데, 목사님께서 보시기에는 지금 어딘가에 정체를 드러내지는 않고는 있지만 적그리스도가 활동을 시작을 했다, 이렇게 생각을 하실 수 있습니까?
First of all, Kushner cannot be the Antichrist, because the Bible is explicitly clear where the Antichrist must come from. In Daniel chapter 7, verse 8, there's a 10-horned beast, and the Bible says in that chapter that these 10 horns represent 10 kings. These 10 kings, this alliance, there's one beast, one kingdom, but 10 kings. These 10 kings must come from Europe. How do we know? Because in Daniel chapter 2, you have a statue, and the last part of that statue, the feet and the toes, are of iron mingled with clay, which is a symbol of the Holy Roman Empire. Those 10 toes are the exact same thing as the ten horns. So that means, since the Bible says those 10 horns, that another horn comes up and uproots three of them, that means the Antichrist is going to come up from this 10-nation union. And since the 10-nation union is also the toes of iron mingled with clay, and since the iron mingled with clay is the Holy Roman Empire, which has ruled Europe over the last 1,000 years, we know for a positive that the Antichrist has to come from Europe. I cannot tell you which nation in Europe he is coming from, but he must come from Europe. So I do not believe there's a possibility at all that Kushner would be the Antichrist.
금년이 이스라엘 건국 70주년이 되는 해이고 5월 14일 날 건국 기념일 날 예루살렘 대사관을 옮긴다고 그랬단 말입니다. 그렇게 되면 이제 진짜 팔레스타인뿐만 아니라 OIC 이슬람 연합 연맹들 이 이슬람 국가들이 가만히 있지 않을 것 같은데요. 어떻습니까? 이스라엘과 아랍 국가들과의 충돌이 일어날까요?
The Bible prophesies a great war involving Islam. In Revelation 9, verse 13 through 21, it talks about the greatest war the world has ever seen. It specifically says there that the war will begin from the Euphrates River. As we have fought against ISIS over the last several years, a scenario has developed. In December of 2015, President Obama and President Putin of Russia got together and made a deal. Because we had had some close calls at Russians fighting Americans, we didn't want that. They made the agreement that Russia would fight ISIS on the west side of the Euphrates, and that the U.S. would fight ISIS on the east side of the Euphrates. Well, that agreement is held since December of 2015. However, the situation it has created is that you've got the world's two greatest nuclear powers on either side of the Euphrates. Between Russia and the United States, they control 90% of the world's nuclear weapons. Well, now that ISIS supposedly is pretty much defeated, now Russia is saying to America, you got to get out because you're here in Syria illegally. The government of Syria did not invite you here. Now, America went in to fight ISIS, which was in danger of taking down the government of Syria and Bashar al-Assad. However, now that that threat seems to be abating, now they're saying we want you out because America is controlling East Syria. Well, the one reason America says we're not leaving is because Iran is over here wanting to build a land bridge from Iran through Iraq, through Syria, all the way to the Mediterranean, because Iran has visions of world empire again, as they have in the past. So they're trying to build this land bridge, but guess what stops them? America. And our friend Israel fears Iran because Iran says repeatedly, we're going to wipe you off the map. You won't exist 25 years from now. So Israel considers Iran an existential threat. So America is there running interference for Israel over here and will not let Iran ship arms to Hezbollah and to its troops in Syria, which is a threat to Israel. Well, on February the 7th, under darkness, the Russian engineers tried to put a bridge across the Euphrates. Our satellites picked it up. We pulled in our bombers, and they bombed that bridge out of the water, and they killed 500 people that day. 200 of them were Russians. Not much has been in the news about it because nobody wants a war to erupt between Russia and the United States of America. But this war is predicted in the Bible that one-third of mankind is going to be killed. So all the tensions in the world are centered at the Euphrates River, even the North Korean situation, because North Korea is allied with Iran. They share technologies together. And if this thing breaks out in all of its fury, then it will become a world war. So all of these things are interwoven. All these world factors are interwoven, and that's the way I understand the situation presently.
트럼프 대통령이 미국 대사관을 예루살렘으로 옮긴다고 했을 때 영국이나 뭐 프랑스, 독일, 일본 이 여러 나라들이 거의 전 세계가 다 반대를 했는데 얼마 전에 얘기를 들어보니까 저 중미에 있는 과테말라라는 나라는 미국과 같이 자기들의 그 이스라엘에 있는 대사관을 예루살렘으로 옮기겠다 이렇게 발표를 했어요. 미국의 대사관 이전에 이어서 과테말라 대사관 이전 다른 나라들도 또 따라서 이렇게 미국 대사관처럼 예루살렘으로 옮겨올 가능성이 있어 보이십니까?
Some of them may. When the vote was taken in the General Assembly on the 21st of December, after President Trump had made his announcement on the 6th of December, there was a vote at the UN Security Council on the 18th. And then on the 21st of December, the General Assembly took a vote. And that vote ended up to condemn the United States. The vote was 128-9. There were 9 countries that voted with America. There were another 35 that abstained. There were 21 that were conveniently absent that day. But there were 9 that stood with the United States and for Israel. It was the United States, Israel, Guatemala was another one. There was also Micronesia, Palau, and a few others, very, very small powers, that also voted with the United States to not condemn the moving of the embassy to Jerusalem. So there may be 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. I do not expect an avalanche. I don't expect a lot of them to do it because most of them have now bought into the theory that we must have a one world government in order to end war. The theory behind everything is this: nationhood causes war. When you have many nations, each one has its own army, then when there's a disagreement, they go to war. But if we would dissolve nations, they claim the nation state structure of our world is outdated because we're being pulled so close together with the internet, with rapid travel. So they say, if we would get rid of all of the armies and put it all under the United Nations, then when there's a disagreement among nations, they could go to the UN Security Council, they could debate it before the Security Council could vote, make a ruling, and everybody has to abide by that. And you won't have any war because there's no armies left except the United Nations. Well, that sounds pretty good to some people. I'm talking about President Obama believed that. Bill Clinton believed that. Many other leaders, both Republican and Democrat here in America, believe that. And many leaders around the world are believing that. There's a fatal flaw in that argument, however. What happens when you get one army ruling the world and that one army comes under the control of an Adolf Hitler? Now you've got the worst tyranny the world has ever seen. People will say, but that won't happen. However, that's exactly what the Bible says is going to happen. Though only it won't be Adolf Hitler, it will be someone worse. The Bible calls him the beast or the Antichrist. So all of these factors are being involved, and it all comes right back to the Jerusalem issue. So the Jerusalem issue is not a side issue. It is at the core and the center of everything, and it will stay there until the Battle of Armageddon.
목사님께서 보시기에는 확실하게 지금 미국의 도널드 트럼프 대통령을 하나님이 쓰고 계신다 이렇게 생각이 되십니까?
Yes, I absolutely believe that whether he means to or not. He either understands what he's doing or God is manipulating him. There's a lot of belief in the world that he's a modern day Cyrus. In the Bible, when the children of Judea were taken down into Babylonian captivity for 70 years, when the kingdom of Babylon was overthrown and was replaced by the kingdom of the Medes and the Persians, Cyrus was the Persian king. And when he heard about the situation that Jerusalem was supposed to be rebuilt and that his name was in the prophecies of the Bible before he was even born, I think it was Daniel who told him this, that Daniel said to him, you know, you're in the Bible? He says, really, what's it say? It says, you're my anointed and you will say, to the temple thou shalt be rebuilt. And Cyrus said, done. He gave the order and all the Jews got to go back, and Cyrus even paid for the rebuild of the temple out of the treasury. So there's a lot of people who believe that President Trump is a modern-day Cyrus. As a matter of fact, when Prime Minister Netanyahu was here to see him on March the 5th, he told him that. He said, President Trump, we believe you are a modern Cyrus. You will go down in history with Cyrus, with Lord Balfour, who gave the Balfour Declaration, and with Harry Truman, who was the first world leader to recognize the legitimacy of the existence of Israel when the nation of Israel was reborn on May the 14th. Well, that's pretty heady company for a guy to be in, but there are people telling him repeatedly, you are Cyrus. And so I do think he has a sense of destiny about him. And now we see Trump facing down the world government, recognizing Jerusalem as the capital. It's a fulfillment of Bible prophecy. So, what will happen with Trump after this term? I don't know. But I know what's going to happen to America. But don't forget, we've got this war that's going to kill one-third of mankind. What I think is going to happen, this war, it could start tomorrow. I do think it would be highly likely that North and South Korea could be involved in the war. The UN's forces will be over the top of Israel and will be pushing Israel back until finally half of the city of Jerusalem will fall to the UN forces. And only the second coming of Jesus will save Israel from the power of the United Nations. One person said, only one life so soon will be passed. Only what's done for Christ will last. That's what we need to realize.